Hello everybody, it's me, a friendly porcupine, and today I bring you some new Mega Castrax Call of Duty, because that's right, they still have not given up on the line. Now everybody, these news aren't entirely super new. I mean, they're the most recent thing Mega Castrax has done for Call of Duty that we know of, but unfortunately, I was a little bit late to the party and I should have made this video a lot sooner, but I had a lot of other videos to do, and yeah. Well, anyways, I'm here to show off the new sets anyways. So enough of that, let's get started. At first we have Captain Price. Now, Mega Castrax is only just sticking to figures, which is sad. I wish they could do, you know, actual builds and sets for the Call of Duty line. It's kind of sad. But anyways, let's move on. One thing I really don't like about the set is why do they have to change the figure stand like that? Couldn't you just keep it the old classic one? You know, they kind of had that military figure, the one that felt like a terrain base plate figure stand. Like, why you keep this one here? I mean, it's nice, right? It has the name Captain Price written on it, so you can display your figures, but it's only good for display. Well, what if you wanted to have Captain Price there, you know, when you display, for example, a whole battlefield? You're not gonna have a whole, like, nice thing. I mean, it just makes it very inconsistent. We could have had a nice base plate. Kind of like how they did with Captain Riley. Remember that old figure? What was it, Captain Pricey Riley? I forgot already, but anyways. That figure, you see how they did the little print on that? Why couldn't they just do that instead of giving us this? Well, anyways, Captain Price right here comes with a Kalashnikov AK-47, of course. It's nice. But remember, every single time Mega Castrax always used to include any AK, then they always include it to make sure that you get that scope piece. I don't know why they decided not to give the scope piece. Whatever, doesn't really matter too much, because the eyes are not painted once again. Looks to me like it's only one eye application, but I don't know. It works, but it makes it look like a knockoff. Knockoffs only do one paint application. What does the official one do? Also do one paint application. So it's like, it makes it feel like it's a knockoff, which is not a good thing you want to do. Anyways, it's also very nice that we get sleeveless arms with the hands, not just gloves, because most of the times we always get the glove ones with the sleeves on, but now we get the full complete thing, which is excellent. I also really like how Captain Price's pants and boots right here, the boots are actually painted, and it's those presidential slacks. So I'm very glad that they're using those molds once again a lot more often. That's an excellent thing. Anyways, enough about you, Captain Price, let's move on to the next figure, General Shepard. Now, this figure to me, I think, is the best out of all of them. Why? Because I just love that nice camel paint design on the entire shirt. Like, wow. That right there is excellent. The boots are nice. The figure is nice. Especially with those one eye applications. Yes, okay, whatever. I'm not gonna rant about that. We'll rant about another time. Anyways, he also comes with a nice painted knife, a nice painted revolver. But unfortunately, it's not that much. And again, this stand, I mean, hey, at least it's better than having the Made in China print right on the base plate, eh? So, I mean, yeah, there's some good things about that too. And look at this! It's also in the Black Series! Wow! Call of Duty gets put in the Black Series, okay! Now, that's what I like. Moving on, we have Logan Walker. This guy's probably from the Call of Duty Ghost game. I haven't played, so I can't say 100% for sure, but I think the figure is nice. I do like how you get double kneecaps, even you get the kneecaps over here to place over that kneecap. So yeah, that's pretty nice. Also, these boots right here, these shoes right here, they're painted. So that's also another excellent touch. Boom. As for that, there really isn't much about the figure, except you get the ski mask in that Call of Duty Ghost style. You get the little scarf, you get that new style of vest, which is nice, of course. And yeah, moving on. We have John Soap McTavish. The whole thing written, and look. They even apostrophize, I assume, is his nickname. Because who would want to name their child Soap? I don't know. Anyways, moving on, here we have a shotgun, which is very, very, very nicely painted. I think it's an excellent touch to include. It's also nice that you get at least another accessory to go with it. And also, what do you guys think of the packaging material? I really like how it uses less plastic, and it looks like it's a lot easier to take the figure out. Which is excellent to me. Because the less plastic is used, I say it's the better. Except, this thing. I wish they just had those bigger stands instead. So much better. Anyways, I really, really like how they did that nice, nice, nice camo for the pants. Excellently well done. And what is this? We have those type of biker gloves? The ones with the little fingertips pointing? Wow! That's pretty cool. Moving on, I also like how this build right here painted. The shirt looks very, very nice. Overall, the figure is an excellent figure. Except for the eyes, of course, but yeah, we'll move on after that. Also, you get a blue scarf, which is nice. Moving on, we have Frank Woods. Who doesn't look anything like Frank Woods? When was the last time you remembered him being bald, huh? Look, he has hair and a bandana. You guys put on the wrong head mold. How do you fuck that up? What happened to him? Or maybe I haven't played the game. Does he lose his hair? Post in the comments down below, because I have not played the game yet, so I don't know if he loses his hair or not, or what happens to him, I don't know. Maybe this is the Frank Woods where he loses his hair. If so, why don't we get the version with the hair and the version without the hair? I don't know. That's Mega Construct for you. Anyways, the M16, of course, is nice. What is that? It looks like a grenade, but it looks more like a cigar to me. Wait, did they make a cigar mold? Yes. That's very interesting. Okay, it makes this set very interesting. Anyways, moving on. We have very nice tattoos. So, wow, your figures can now get even more tattoos. So look at that. And look at that. That's actually a shirt, not the skin. So it's not a completely shirtless figure. He has a shirt, but it's more of like a tank top shirt. Which is nice, I like that. Also the pants, the camo on the pants. Very well done, Mega Construct. Even though you only gave us figures, this you did them well. Except for the eyes and except for the figure stand. But whatever, moving on. To another care package! Yes, that's right, we're getting another care package. And, I first must say, I really, really like the paint job on the guns. Always do the paint job on the guns very well for their care package sets. Now, I wish the care package could actually go into a figure trooper pack, but unfortunately, not needed. To me, it seems a bummer, but yeah, I'll save that rant for another day. Anyways, I do like the figure's pants. You get a black one, but you get those type of boots, which are very nice. However, to me, the figure, it's little bit, it's too generic. It's like we keep getting that same hat with the head mold each and every single time. I really got tired. But whatever, I mean, overall I think the figure is nice except that head mold. I wish they could have gave us, you know, something else. Maybe another head mold completely or something, you know what I mean? Anyways, I think the care package is well done. I do like the excellent paint job they've done on it. I think all the weapons are excellent. And look at this! This is what I'm talking about! Throw a figure stand like that! Instead of throwing, what the hell is this? This display, I mean, I like this! So much better. It works so much better. It can fit in like in a lot more scenarios. When you make it like this, you limit it to only being display. This includes more play, but also display, which I like that balance. Here it's like, it can only be display. It has its name on it. It can only be display. To me, it just seems limited. I mean, it's nice, but it's also like, yeah. Yeah. Well, everybody, that's basically all the news I got for you today. If you enjoyed the video today or learned something new, be sure to leave it a like. And as always, if you want to see more content from me, a friendly porcupine, such as news, knockoff reviews, everything like that, be sure to subscribe and I'll catch you in the next video, comrades. Take care, everybody. Oh, and before I go, what do you think about these Mega Construct Call of Duty sets, huh? Do you think they're super cool? Do they intrigue you? Me? I mean, they're nice.